You asked specifically about how does this differ? Why am I at odds with the type of policy? You know, when Dave Ramsey talks about whole life being a bad thing and so on, and many people agree with him. And I will say this, that I believe that Dave has unquestionably helped many, many people turn their financial lives around. And I agree with many of the principles that he teaches. We do differ on a couple key points. Number one, that you must risk your money in the stock market to grow a substantial nest egg. Number two, that any kind of whole life insurance should be avoided. Because, you know, Chickie, the truth is that the stock market is right back where it was more than a decade ago.
Mm-hmm.
But inflation has slashed the purchasing power of your dollars by more than 30% in that period of time. Well, you could have gotten the same result putting your money in your mattress and skipped the nail biting and the sleepless nights. And the truth is, I mean, isn't that the truth? I mean, millions
Absolutely.
Of Americans are suffering, and it breaks my heart. If you ask, and I often ask this, I love asking this question, I'll ask it of your listeners. Do you know how much your nest egg will be worth when you're ready to tap into it? And most people that I've surveyed admit that they haven't got a clue. To me, that's a surefire prescription for financial insecurity rather than financial peace of mind. And there's a couple interesting facts about, you know, I've been calling them Wall Street's dirty little jiggers, secrets. Do we have time to go into what I think some of the dirty little secrets are?
Oh, absolutely.
Okay, all right. And then I'll get back to, I promise, I will get back to the difference between the type of whole life policy that people like Dave Ramsey talk about and a bank on yourself policy. See, my husband and I have been investing in stocks and real estate and many other things basically since 1987. And we have never even come close to getting decent long-term results. When we got frustrated doing it ourselves, we hired three of the top financial planners and asset managers in the country to manage our retirement plan portfolio. And, you know, they all charge hefty fees, and all three of them lost us money during the longest-running bull market in history. A blindfolded monkey throwing darts could have done that. So we began to wonder, well, was it just us? Were we just like defective when it came to investing? So we decided to dig deeper, and we discovered some things that really shocked me and that Wall Street does not want you to know. And number one is that the typical investor in mutual funds has actually been losing 1% per year after adjusting for inflation over the last 20 years, and this is according to a very well-respected financial research firm called Dalbar Incorporated. And I actually believe that the idea that you do have to risk your money, you should risk your money in the stock market, and that will long-term give you financial security and help you grow a sizable nest egg, I believe that that is responsible for more broken dreams of retirement than anything else. And another myth that another reality that they don't want you to know about is if you actually start looking at the history of the market, it's the norm, not the exception, for the Dow to go nowhere for painfully long periods of time, up to 17 years, up to 25 years. I mean, how are we supposed to have financial security with that type of performance? And as my husband and I found out the hard way, hiring an expert isn't necessarily the answer. Research shows that 80% of all mutual funds underperform the overall market, and 80% of all investment advisors underperform the overall market. So to me, it's kind of like a losing scenario.